Hello everyone, and welcome on my unboxing video of Heroes of Land, Air and Sea, the second print. Let's start by opening the big box. At first sight, a lot of paper filling to protect the boxes inside. First, we have the Pestilence Booster Pack, which includes 14 new spell cards, 2 new vessels, and some additional card sleeves. Next, we have the card sleeves for the base game and all the other cards. Let's remove the paper filling here. And here you can find the large neoprene playmat, which is a very nice feature to add to the game. Later in this video, I will zoom in some more details on the different components. Next on the unboxing is the big box inside of the even bigger box. The box will contain basically everything which was inside of the Everything Base Pledge on the Kickstarter. The first thing we find in the box is some kind of a paper filler. I don't know what is exactly the meaning of this one. Maybe you can comment here in the video if you know or recognize this. I will put a detailed picture later in the video. Next is the Siege Engines mini expansion. This one features 6 siege constructs. Like mercenaries, these units can be recruited by any player without prerequisite. Let's dig further in the box. Aha, next we find the Nomads mini expansion. It features 2 different play modes. You can either use the Nomads as mercenaries or as NPCs, non-player characters. What do we still find here on the side? The mercenaries packs. Included in this pledge we have mercenaries packs 1, mercenaries packs 2 and Mercenaries Pack 3. I will detail later in this video out what is inside of those mercenary packs. Last mercenary pack to unbox is Mercenaries Pack 2, which contains only 2 minis, the McMaster Sith and Balador. Now let's move to the 3 core boxes. First, we have the Heroes of Land, Air and Sea base game. As you can see, it's a nice thick box with some nice artwork and a very good detailed overview what you can find inside of this box. Next we find the box Heroes of Land, Air and Sea, Order and Chaos, which contain 4 new races, the Lionkin, Undead, Lizardfolk and Goblins. And last but not least, the real reason for this Kickstarter, Heroes of Land, Air and Sea, the Pestilence box. Let's take a look at some pictures of the boxes. I said before, please comment if you recognize this one. Now let's take a look at the neoprene playmat, which I included as an add-on in my Pledge Manager. It's a 48 to a 34 inch playmat. As you can see, the mat is very nice detailed and with some very nice and bright colors. Now let's move to the next step and see what we find in the big box Heroes of Land, Air and Sea, the base game. What I like about these boxes is that there is something carved out of the side box so that it easily opens. I think this can be a very good suggestion for all the other vendors to make their boxes like that. First we find some quick reference card with the action selection overview, playing around and also the exploration token overview. Next is the rulebook. Nicely detailed and some pictures accompanying explaining the rules. Very nicely done. Here you find an instruction guide in how to assemble the different towers, the vessels, as well as the sea vessel and the air vessels. The punch boards which contain those vessels, both for the towers, the main tower and the sea and air vessels. What is nice is that they have slightly different designs for the humans, the orcs, the dwarves and the elves. Very nicely done. And the thickness and the quality of the boards is sufficient. Here a punch board with the exploration tokens. And the air vessels for the four races. Now we come to the four faction boards of the different races, which look very nice. Good details and very nice brightful colors. They also facilitate the single play mode. As you can see, the faction boards are printed on some thick cardboard, which is necessary because they will be heavily used. Now let's take a look at the stances for the air vessels. At first sight, they look very broken. Let's open the back. None of those have survived the packaging and the transport. This is a very big disappointment. And as you can see, they are not even easy to repair here. So I will order new ones in the customer support desk. Let's see what else we find in this box. The giant board game. To be honest, I'm not so fond of the quality of this board game. That's also a reason why I ordered the extra neoprene playmat, for which I'm very happy I did. Now let's unbox the miniatures, the cards and the tokens. contains 80 miniatures, the faction tokens, the resource tokens, the first player token, 12 hero cards, 28 tactic cards and 60 mini spell cards. I will show some detailed pictures of the miniatures later in the unboxing video. Now let's take a look at the cards and the quality of the cards, both for the prints on it and the quality of the cards itself. The look and feel and the thickness of the cards, they really meet my expectations. And the prints on them will also help later for painting the miniatures. Now let's take a look at the small cards. Again, very good quality cards and very nice prints on it. Now one of my favorite things, the tokens. The first player token. And the resource token. 15 resource tokens. Those look very nice and are a very good add-on to the game and the gameplay. Let's take a look at some detailed pictures of the miniatures. The heroes of the dwarves, the elves, the humans, and last but not least, the orcs. Let's continue to unbox the second core box, Heroes of Land, Air and Sea, Order and Chaos. This box contains, as said, four new races, the Lion King, Undead, Lizard Folk and the Goblins. I like the prints and the design of these boxes. Let's first take a look at the plastic stances of the air vessels and see if they survived the trip. And again, these as well, like the one of the core box, didn't survive the packaging and the trip. Very disappointing. So I hope I get a very good customer experience with the help desk. The 5-6 player rules that come with the Chaos and Order box. And like in the core box, the punch cards for the different towers, the vessels. Again, very nice that every race has some other details and that the designs are slightly different for each and every one of them. The air vessels. I'll try to assemble some of them so that I can take pictures and that I can show them later in this unboxing video. The faction cards that come with the new races, the Lion King, Undead, Lizard Folk and Goblins. The extension of the game board needed in the 5 to 6 player modus. And like in the core box, also in Order and Chaos, 2 trays with minis, with cards and with tokens. Again, let's take a look at some detailed pictures of the miniature. The Heroes of the Undead, the Lionkin race, the Heroes of the Lizardfolk, and the Green Goblins. Now let's open the last core box. The one for this Kickstarter was initiated is the Pestilence box. Basically a 7-player expansion with 2 new races. The Merfolk, for which we have an extra blue plastic cover included in this box, which represents the water. And the Birdfolk, for which we have a floating continent included in this box. And this continent is based on 4 stands. As you can see, this core box is slightly damaged during the transport, which is a pity. The rules for the 7-player game, of course including a description of the Merfolk and the Birdfolk. Let's take a look at the plastic stances and hope that this box, they survived it. Let's take a look. These are the stances that are supposed to carry the floating island. They look pretty much intact. I'm happy with this. The plastic stances for the air vessels also made the trip and survived it. Again, an instruction guide to assemble the pieces. Description of the tokens. And you know the drill, the punch boards for the towers and for the vessels. The faction cards for the 2 extra races. The blue plastic cover, which represents the water for the Merfolk, and the punch board for the floating island, which needs to be put on the 4 plastic stances. And because we only have 2 extra races, 1 plastic tray containing the miniatures. And the cards that come with this box. And the tokens for these races. A picture of the heroes of the Birdfolk. And of course, the Merfolk. Let's now take a look at the little boxes. We start with the Pestilence booster pack, as I mentioned, also containing some card sleeves and two extra vessels. Now let's take a look at the three mercenary packs. Mercenary pack 1, 2 and 3. Containing basically both the miniatures and the cards that come with these miniatures. In the mercenaries pack 1 we find the Gamelin, the Knoke, Charles and Betula. Let's open the second mercenaries pack. As being said before, this one will contain the Mechmaster Sith and Balador, which has only two miniatures, but they are slightly bigger as the other miniatures in the mercenary packs. Let's open the last pack, Mercenary Pack 3, which contains Cthulhu, Beelzebub, Hedadonna and Dayhorn. I don't know who invented these names, but they are in there. Like with the core boxes, now we take a look at some more detailed pictures of the miniature itself. Now we will open the remaining things of the package. Starting with the Siege Engines mini expansion, including the 6 Siege Constructs. A pack of card sleeves that together with the Pestilence booster pack I'm able to sleeve all the cards included in the different core boxes and the expansions. And let's now take a look at the Nomads mini expansion. With the Nomads mini expansion, it features 2 different play modes as being said, so you can either use the Nomads as mercenaries or as NPCs. If used as mercenaries, a player is able to recruit 3 Nomads to join their army. In many ways, they function as an enhanced service. If used as NPCs, they cannot be controlled by any single player for long. Each round, one is added by the player who starts the round. The regions adjacent to the Nomads produce 1 fewer resource. Here we come to the overall verdict of this unboxing and the quality of this Kickstarter. Overall, I'm quite happy with the delivery time, the packaging, the protection, besides one box that has a little bit of a harm during the transportation. I like the quality and I also like the artwork, but I don't like the inlays and the organization of the box. And the thing that I didn't like neither was the board game, the game board. That's also one of the reasons why I ordered the extra neoprene playmat. And I was not so happy with the fact that the plastic stances came broken. But in the meantime, I've sent a mail to the support desk and I hope they send me replacements quite quickly.